is up, guys? I am Welsh Boyo, and we are back with another video on Horizon Zero Dawn, and I'm going to be doing a review today. I ain't feeling well at the moment, so if I sound a bit iffy, you know why. And also, my mic's only coming out on mono, so I don't know how or why, but if you're wearing headphones and you can't hear me, that's probably why. Let's just jump in. I've played about a good 15 hours of this game already. It is incredible. By far one of my favourite games I've played on PS4 at the moment. I'm just going to get in to show you a little bit on it. I'm going to explain why it's so good, why I like it the way it is, and just, why most ratings I've given this game either a 9, 9.5 or up. So I will explain a little bit why that is, and I can see their point of view on it. But let me just turn my mic up a little bit to see if you guys are actually picking me up.
I hope you are. Yeah, that's okay.
Right. Yeah, this game is probably one of the best looking games I've played. It is absolutely stunning. It's really nice, really well done. I mean, I haven't found any glitches, to be honest, so that's a good sign. Right. I'm seeing the little screen where you guys are going to be seeing. And, yeah, it looks quite pretty from what you guys are seeing, but if you could see what I'm seeing right now, then like all the colour popping and stuff, it's stunning. Right. Oh, I don't know if you can hear my controller again, but I'm going to press right analog to actually go through it to this view. You can like scan them, you can see what parts, if you take off them, what damage you'll do. I'm gonna get out of here quickly. I'm gonna go back to the to one of the main places where you first start off, and we'll have a wander about and just show you a little bit on the game and how it works, because it's this whole fast travel system. If you are picking this game up and you are just starting to play, you will notice then I could just fast travel wherever I want, whenever I want, basically, and that is not the case when you first start playing. You have to get something called fast travel packs, and these packs allow you to fast travel once per one, well, just once, and once per pack, and you have to buy more. But if you get about 4 hours into the game, if that, maybe a little less, because I kind of went off on a tandem and kind of bloody explored the wasteland and explored everywhere. But if you go to one of the big cities, what the storyline kind of draws you to, eventually you'll be able to unlock a golden pack, fast travel pack, and that one is unlimited. You can just do it as many times, and just as long as you don't sell it, you're fine. Right, if we have any veggies about to watch, close your eyes, because you guys are not going to like this. Yep, there you go. Kill the turkey. That's my Christmas done. You can go up, you can search for turkeys, fatty meat. There's a lot of hunting, a lot of... If you guys ever played Far Cry Primal, you will know exactly what I'm on about you. Because you can create... Hang on, let me just turn this off. It's bugging me a second. There you go. Yeah, as well as that, right. I'll go back onto our screen in a second. Crafting. This is what I was on about. With the fatty meat I just picked up, I can create stuff like, what was it, potions. I haven't got enough yet, because you've got to get three fatty meat and two rich meat, and you create a health potion, health boosts, full potions. These, it says three, one out of three, zero out of three, no, you can build your pouch and you can build on it a lot, in fact. And the same goes for when you modify your outfits, you'll have stuff called these. You'll have, kind of what you have to call them now. You can call them mods? Yeah, modifications. And you'll pick up these modifications throughout playing the game, and just the more beasts you fight, the more you unlock. And if you're lucky enough like me to pre-order this game you will have the Nora Lookout outfit already. That's a really nice one, but I don't tend to use it because it's not that good. My favourite one's that, because the beasts can't hear you, or that one because it's really powerful, really strong, breaks projectile attacks from, you do have human enemies in this game, and that's why. Modify your weapons. I don't think I've ever used, I think I've used that once. And the same goes for the rope caster. I haven't used them a hell of a lot. My main go-to bow is the hunter bow. And the shadow sharp shot bow. But it's hard to say, especially when you feel ill. And of course you can modify these as well. You have modifications here that I put on. And you go to inventory, obviously you can change your weapons. Buy different outfits. Different outfits do different stuff. This is the modifications. I've actually upgraded my pack so I can just pick up a load of mods and then just go nuts. Your resources, this is the pack you're going to really want to just do out. Just completely and totally stock it up as much as you can. That, and maybe not the outfits, because you can buy one and keep it for like the entire game if you really find one as handy. Treasure boxes. Now these are what you collect from each quest. Each quest you get, if I open that up now, I picked up a detonating blast traps. Probably not going to use them, but hey. V is obviously like any normal game these days, you have to go find collectibles for someone. These are just some of those collectibles. There's quite a lot in the world, to be honest. Ammo, obviously you can see what ammo you've got. Potions and traps, you can see how many you've got. Obviously, quests, you have what's active, so you can see what active ones you got. The main quests, which is quite nice, I like how they've split the main ones up, so you don't have to flick through them. You have your side quests, what's quite nice to see, because they're all leveled out for you over there. You have something called errands, which you don't have to do, they help, but no, it's not particularly... If you miss them, then, no.
Who cares?
Basically. Bandit camps, you go, and the same as Far Cry. Far Cry does very well, how you have to liberate different sections. The same as Just Cause, it's basically the same. Ah! Gone off it. Right. Tall necks, now I've completed all of these already. These are the big, giant, dinosaur looking things with a massive necks, where you climb up and you scan it. A bit like Eagle Vision from Assassin's Creed. You will scan it and the entire ground will come into play and you can see where to go. These are just like, you know, your normal challenges, your time trial ones, your shooting ones, cauldrons. Now these are, the whole idea of this is you can take over machines and you can some of them are corrupted, some of them you can just take over, and like you can ride on some like horses and you can have others to come into battle with you. And the more cauldrons you go down and explore, you unlock more beasts you can override. These are called corrupted zones. These are where like the beasts have been taken over by something else. You cannot take them over as well. If you wipe them out, then that place becomes a lot easier and a lot nicer for you to roam. Obviously, your normal tutorials is highly recommended you do these. I haven't done them yet. I know it's kind of contradicting myself here, but it's like, do them. Because you get basically XP for just
doing
bugger all. Notebook, I've never really gone into this. It basically just tells you all about the animals you've seen. I haven't seen. Oh, it's two I haven't seen. I've seen that one. That one's scary as shit. I think I found that one already somewhere. Probably seen it, but you have to like scan them. Now I'm scanning. Collectibles, data points, you know, your normal progression stuff in games. skills nicely put out for you, because it is one thing I will say about this. It kind of really gets on my nerves, because you have foraging. We still have like combat override, where you think combat override would be on brave, and stuff like, you know, heavy lifter, concentration, and that would be on prowler. But anyway, it don't really bother me. I have a nice little skill set up, and I show you, and if you really want to, sometimes some of them, yeah, we have little videos to show you what to do, so it's quite nice. Right, now just jump back into the game. Oh wait, hang on, one thing I will show everyone before I start. The map is huge. Everything you can see here, you can explore. It is insanely big. My biggest recommendation is getting that fast travel pass, the golden one. Fast travel pack, really, as soon as you can, even if, as soon as you get to the city and you can see you can buy it. Or like, basically when you buy stuff, you have to like, hunt and you trade in stuff, because of course, this is apocalyptic, they don't really have currency. So basically your currency is going around and hunting stuff in the wasteland. What's quite nice, but at the same time a little bit of a pain in the butt.
Right.
If you're gonna hear something going on now, it's me sticking a headphone in because I kind of forgot to turn my TV up, so you guys can actually hear the music and stuff in this game. I can't hear nothing at the moment. Right, now I can. Yay. Ah, there you go. Microphone switched to headset.
Yeah, I know. Can you guys still hear it?
Let me just check that. No, you cannot. In that case, I will just unplug it and see where we go from here. Yeah, I know. I can't hear it. Whatever. Hang on, I'll actually go get my turn up a little bit. There you go. Right, now I can hear it. Hey. So now I'll know if any beasts are gonna kill me. What will probably happen quite a lot. Right, let's go for it. Right, this is your scanning tool, a bit like Batman the Arkham games. I'm gonna compare this to a lot of games just so like the broad sense of you who've played, who are genuine gamers and played a lot of games, you will know what I'm understand. But even if you haven't and you've seen them, kinda know where I'm going. So like foxes, fox over there, what's that? Another fox. Come on. Grazer. Okay, we don't wanna piss him off because quite nice. But I'll see if I can go and overwrite one. I'll show you guys what I was on about. Right, these things over there are called Watchers. They're basically like the raptors of this game. I have upgraded her, like, her, the slow motion. Asteroid gamma. Oh well, you don't want them to see you. If they see you, then it's not really game over, but it's just... But if I do this and I wait for him to come back up here, I will show you a little bit. I will take over this one, actually. I'll show you a little bit of a taking over system. Hold to overwrite. So I hold triangle. She overwrites him, and then he will go and kill whoever basically would normally kill me. Oh, that's a bit weird.
You want a rocker? I haven't seen that before.
But I do like how the sun is setting and moving, so that's pretty cool. I haven't seen that before. I can tell those grazers are really pissed off over there now, they're gonna run. That's fine. As you can see, you've got like the red bar up the left corner. And basically, when you go around the city, around the map, you'll find these medic ones. Pick them up, the green bar will go up. And if I press up on the D-pad now, well, not now because I haven't got injured yet, but I'll probably show you in a bit. But if I pick up words, I've pretty much. It's not highly recommended this in, but I'm going to do it just for you guys. Basically, I've got 49 out of 50. If I hold X, she crafts the arrows, and the same goes for every arrow. So bar one. Again, fire ones. Fire ones need blaze as well. Like, we special canisters we can get around steam. We'll do them up. We'll do all my arrows up, screw it. No, we won't, because I haven't got enough. Ah, but we will. Nope. Okay, we're gonna stick back to that. Right. Let's see. Let's get into some action, is it? Did I want to take over? Did I take him over? Oh. Show a bit of the.
So much for being careful.
As you can see, bodies laying there. You just go up, you hold triangle, you search him, he comes up with a watcher lens where you can see the legs then quickly. That is basically, that lets you trade, you can trade that in for different costumes, different stuff. I will get to what I mean, and I will show you guys exactly what I mean when I say you can trade in stuff. I don't really need nothing, but I'll buy something just to show you guys. Run down here quickly. Leg it, woman. Right. Right. Animals as well drop certain stuff. So when it comes to crafting that, you sometimes you need something special. So what do I need? Crafting. Carrier. Weapons actually, no. Arrow. I need a fox skin. So that tells me, obviously, I need to go hunt some foxes. Ah, look at the cute little bunny. Should we kill a bunny? No. Killed enough bunnies in my time. I think that's actually one of the first things you get told to do is kill a bunny. Yeah, this world is massive, so you might be running for ages. I think my mother came in and saw me playing this game, and her first words were, "You do a lot of running in this game, don't you?" Yep. Sadly, you do. Right. Show you a little bit of condom. Fuck. A little bit of combat. Basically, them things there. Right, let's go off it. Them things there. Blaze canisters. The weakness is to destroy them on the back. So if I zoom in, hold her, bust that one off.
Simple.
It's quite nice, quite easy. You don't have to be a pro to know about this. You just have to. As soon as you get it, you get it. It took me ages to get it, to be fair. I kind of didn't listen to what people were saying in like the reviews and stuff like that, and all the Let's Plays about it, being like, oh yeah, by the way, they show you the weak spots and utilize it. I thought, it'll be fine. You know what I mean? It's me. I'll just get a powerful bow and shoot her in the head a couple times. It'll be fine. No, you die very quickly doing that. Right, watchers are pretty fun because they have no weak spots except for their eye. So you have to really get in good. Like that. So I highly recommend doing up your slow motion detect, well, slow motion stuff. Right. That's probably the easiest I've ever killed one of them things.
Yeah, guys, don't ever listen to me when it comes to, ooh, fox.
Yeah, I did just brutally murder a fox, by the way. Sorry. Yeah, don't ever listen to me when it comes to how you should fight in games, because I am awful. I mean, like I said, Vark, then I utilized his weak spots. It took him down in, what, how many was that? 4 arrows?
Something like that.
So yeah, never listen to me. Ever. Right, I'm going to shoot us up the map a little bit. because there's not many enemies here, and I know the further you go up the map, like here, is incredible. I mean, up here is pretty... There's one spot around here. I think it's... There it is, Stormbird site. That, I might give it a go in a bit, just to show you guys, just to show you me epically failing. So in our case, but we go to this campfire. I'll show you what I mean by the trading currency. Right, the story, I don't want to say a lot on, because I haven't completed it yet. I've gone off on one, I've done my own stuff with the game, I've enjoyed it. If you heard that was just my battery pack falling off my controller. Lucky my controller's fully charged. Ha. But, yeah, the story... Story takes a very different approach to many games. Many games, you basically see the outcome before it happens, know what I mean? It's like Batman the Arkham games. Arkham Knight. Maybe Arkham City you couldn't guess, because Arkham City was just incredible. Arkham Knight, though, you could kind of guess that Jason Todd was... By the way, if you haven't played it, spoiler alert, but if you don't know about it by now, you... Where have you been? Basically, the Arkham Knight turned out to be Jason Todd, aka the Red Hood. Everyone saw Arkham, I mean, I called it months before, as soon as I saw the symbol on Arkham Knight's chest, I was like, yeah, that's Jason Todd. I mean, it's no biggie. I mean, the only other person it can be is Damian Wayne, but that wasn't gonna happen. So it's like, there's a lot of games you can actually guess the story to before they happen. This one I haven't, to be honest. This one is still very much up in the air, and I've put a lot of hours into this already. Right, we have a merchant. What is up, merchant? Right. You see on the left, right-hand side, you have metal shards and you have blaze. That's how many blaze he wants to trade with you and how many metal shards you need. So if I go down to something I haven't got, so let's get a really good one. Have I got a... yeah, I think I've got on. Yeah, no, I haven't got it, but I haven't got the shards for it anyway. Basically, it tells me that I need 800 metal shards and I haven't got them. But it also tells me I need the... what does that say? Luminaras? Braiding? Luminaras? I don't know, but braiding thing anyway. I have two of them and he needs two. And it's not just this, you do that with weapons. The more powerful the weapon, the more stuff you need. So obviously you get to the shadow bow, what I've got. Lucky enough. There you go, the shadow sharp shot bow. I haven't got that yet. I am going to get it at some point. Need one sawtooth heart and 800 metal shards. Now, unless you have like a lot of shards and you just go around collecting shards for just for pleasure, you are fine, because it's actually in one of the cities. I'll show you in case you are. Oh wait, wrong one. In case you're actually playing it and you don't know where. It's a big one. You can't really miss it. There you go. The machine resources, if you go to that guy, he sells different animal parts. He sells them quite expensive. I think the sawtooth one will probably set you back 800 shards. So that's basically, you need a hell of a lot. But, yeah, right. Do you guys want to see me fight this, Stormbird? Probably. You probably want to see me die trying to do it. I think I attempted it the other day and just epically failed every single time. Have I gone off arrows? Yeah, you know what? We're gonna give it a go. Yeah, that's it. Wish me luck, because I'm... Oh, crap. I just tried to merge my controller with the table. Yeah, wish me luck on this, because... probably gonna fail epically, but hey, who knows? I might actually pull through. Yay! Especially if I take the advice of what everyone has been telling me and just go for like the weak spots. Apparently, they keep. I saw one, I think it was IGN, and they had like the noob. What was it? The noob, the pro, and the, I don't know, like the mediocre guy. And they were all like playing and fighting the Stormbird and seeing who could do the furthest and get the furthest. Obviously the pro done it. No, the pro was awesome. Right. Climbing in this is pretty hard because you can't see where to climb. In the snowy regions, anyway. I mean, other parts, I quite like that, the slow motion. Other parts, it's not so bad because, like, in a forestry, they show you in bright yellow where you can climb. So, it's, again, it's not too bad. I do love the whole slow motion because it makes you feel. Oh, are you gonna get it? Please get it. I mean, because like the story to this is really good. Like I said, it keeps you guessing. It really does.
Ugh, this scrapes.
Where do I go from here? I think I might have to jump over to there. Yeah, it is. It's over here. I'm gonna jump back. This is probably the biggest creature you fight in the game, or I've fought in the game, anyway. Oh, hi! Yes, nice to meet you. Hi. Where am I going? I'm not even going the right way anymore. Pretty sure I set a campfire up there. Yeah. That sucks, doesn't it? Yeah, you know what, we'll fast travel there and we'll carry on going up and up and up and eventually we'll get there. It's probably going to be quite a long video this is because well, it's the first, I'm not going to show much of this game. It's an amazing game and I kind of want everyone to go out and try for themselves. But this is one of them games where if you have a PlayStation Pro, like I'm lucky enough to have, I haven't got a 4K TV, but no, that's in the works. But at the moment, it's one of them games, if you have a PlayStation Pro, you need it. It's not that, oh, you could play it or could get away with not playing it. You need it. This game looks stunning on the Pro. Probably in 4K, it's going to be even better again. You know, no doubt. Like I said, I'm very lucky at the moment. You know, I've got PlayStation Pro, just hang up TV. If you have. Oh, hang on, Fox. Fox? That's not the Stormbird, by the way. That's good, isn't it? It is too. Hey. I didn't get him. Then I got him. Why are you not hitting anything on him? Probably not. Ass rock! Ow. basically, I pressed up to see my health regen. You can also unlock 2 arrows if you want. I've unlocked one, so if you jump, you start going slow motion. Very handy for times, I guess. I got Chico shot, he's down. Run, run, run. It's just unpredictable. It's brilliant. For wing. I don't think that's it. Oh hell no, he's trying to get away. We're not on that. Dark Souls, you will know that Roland is like your favorite past tense.
What are you doing?
Down, surprisingly. Whew, that was bloody hard. See, this is what I'm on about. Modifications, you get a lot better ones the harder enemy you fight. Oh, I have Crystal Braider now. Yay! I needed one of them for like one of the powerful I can't remember if it was one of the costumes or one of the bows. But anywho, there you go, I've just killed myself a Stormbird. And I will not be doing that anytime soon in a rush. Again. Because that was bloody hard. Fair play. Yeah, just heal myself a little bit. Don't know how many bloody arrows I got left. Do we change in a satchel? No, I don't. Ah, oh, sucks. Right, we'll put that back on. Right, anyway, guys, that was how you take down a Stormbird. If you really, really, really was that.
Satchel, itches.
You get the Shadowhunter bow. Make a fudge ton of arrows, including precision arrows, fire arrows, a lot of fire arrows, in fact. Hunter arrows, and hardpoint arrows. Shock wire trap, because that brought him down for a little bit. Well, meant I could actually get to his chest. But easier. I don't know what she's doing. Snow, yay, I like snow. But yeah, this game is incredibly well done. I mean, just look at her. What about her? Let me get out in the sun. Oh, wrong way. There you go. I mean, the detail. Everything, what they've done, from the foliage to the skin details to the clothes. The only little thing that bugs me is like her hair, like goes through the bow, and the hair like goes through the clothing. But that's a small, real nitpicking little tiny thing to come up with. I mean, look at her. She interacts with the world. If you stay still, she interacts. The characters interact with you differently. It's really good. Really, really nice, really fun game to play, really fluid. The combat is so fluid, it's unbelievable. Like, flicking from bow to that spear attack is incredible. You know, you can just, 1 minute, just bang, flash, and then go straight back to bow.
Know what I mean?
It's so fluid, and it's so nice to use. And the whole precision aiming like that, Red Dead done it so well. And obviously Red Dead 2 is coming out soon. Yeah, see, she's interacting. Now we're in a blizzard. She interacts with the snow differently and stuff like that. It's really nice. Yeah, you can collect rocks as well. I don't care. Screw it. But it's amazing, guys. If you have a PlayStation 4, pick it up. If you have a PlayStation 4 Pro, pick it up. It's one of them games what you will not regret. I'm going to turn the audio down a bit because I can see it peeking. But, yeah, get it. If you ask me, out of 10, I would give this a 9.5. It's little bits. Certain stuff is quite repetitive, and even though there's a lot of stuff you can do in the world, just like the whole climbing up the, what are they called? Tall neck. climbing up one of them gets repetitive after a while. I mean, he's only 5 in the game, so I think it's 5, isn't it? Let's just check that. Quests, tall necks. Yep, 5. You know what I mean? So it's like, I'm a bandit camp, so they get really repetitive, really quick. But it's so much fun to do, because you feel like a pure badass just going up against like a load of bandits, and you're there with a bow and arrow, taking them all out. There is guns on the game, in the game, you can pick them up, like machine, miniguns, you know, the proper Gatling gun style. You pick them up, they're heavy as hell, you can't carry them around for too long. But yeah, if you're thinking and you're in debates about getting Horizon Zero Dawn, if you like, imagine a third person Far Cry Primal with a hell of a lot of, like, upgrades to it, then you've got Horizon. It's a good game. The storyline is incredible so far. I haven't guessed what's going to happen in the end. I really don't want to guess, to be honest, because it could change at any point. Yeah, if you're thinking about getting it, you have the money, you want to buy a new game, what you can just, you know, get your teeth into and just play for hours on end and just get lost in the world.
This one.
And this is my review on that. 9.5 out of 10 I would give this, because it's just an incredible game. They've done so well on it. Little nitpicking things bug me in the game, but that's me being picky. This game is stunning. Get it. Just really get it. But yeah, until the next time, guys, that's my review on Horizon Zero Dawn. The next one I will probably do now is... Ooh, I actually don't know, because there's a few games coming out tidy what I like a look off, and I will let you know when... At the moment, we're doing out the streaming room for me. Well, just I'm having to share it, but it's kind of a streaming room, so I'll have like a constant setup, so it won't be so long of a delay between videos from now on. I might actually do a update video on the whole room, just to show you guys about it. It's gonna be bright orange, I love it. but yeah, I don't think you guys will see the orange, or sadly, because the sofa's going against the other side. But I'll still show you. I'll show you guys in an update video. But until the next time, have fun. Pick up Horizon Zero Dawn. Stay safe. And just have a nice time. Hope you're all good, guys.
And I'll see you next time. Bye.